For the second time in 3 weeks, the Western Michigan football team ventured into Big Ten country, traveling to Champaign, Illinois last Saturday to face the Fighting Illini. Running through some big holes created by the Bronco offensive line, sophomore running back Jamari Bogan rushed for 189 yards and 2 touchdowns. But defense was the big story. Led by the D-line, the Broncos held Illinois to just 315 yards of total offense and only 3 yards rushing. Western Michigan goes to 3-0, including 2 wins over Big Ten opponents in the same season for the first time in school history. Final score, Western Michigan 34, Illinois 10. I'm Robin Hook. Coming up, head coach PJ Fleck joins me for all the highlights of Western Michigan at Illinois. It's week 3 of Bronco Review after this timeout.
Bronco Review is a production of Western Michigan University Athletics and WMU Media Services and is brought to you in part by Greenleaf Trust, financial security from generation to generation. Trust is in their name for a reason. They've earned it.
A part of being a member at Arbor Financial Credit Union is the relationships and personal attention you get from our helpful and knowledgeable staff. But we realize you don't always have time for that. With Arbor Financial's secure mobile app, you can quickly check your balance, pay a bill, deposit a check, or find an ATM. In between, well, everything else. Visit us online at arborfcu.org for more information. Arbor Financial Credit Union. Bank here, grow here.
Little Caesars, home of the $5 Hot and Ready Classic, is driving your taste buds crazy with our new loaded Crazy Bread Bites for just $4. We start with our world-famous Crazy Bread, cut into delicious bite-sized pieces. Then we amp up the flavor with creamy cheddar cheese sauce, mozzarella and Munster cheese, and tasty applewood bacon, all baked to perfection. Need more kick? We've added a side of jalapenos. Try our loaded Crazy Bread Bites for just $4, only at Little Caesars.
Pizza, pizza. Hi, I'm Jim Vandenberg with Maple Hill Subaru. Maple Hill and Subaru, they're becoming synonymous with best of quality for the love, for the trust, everything that you want in buying a car. Consumers Magazine puts them as number one year after year. The only brand that's had 3 Motor Trend Car of the Year Awards. The only SUVs that have ever repeated that many times in the past 5 years. We're proud to be a Subaru dealer.
How's it going? Nice to meet you guys. I have these 2 laptops. We're gonna each download a TV show. I'm gonna download it on Xfinity, and you guys are gonna download it with AT&T UVerse, and we're gonna see who goes faster. Go.
Well, this is a no-brainer so far.
How's AT&T doing?
Struggling.
I'm ready to go. We'll wait for you guys.
Looks like we're gonna be waiting for a while.
Don't let UVerse slow you down. Upgrade to an Xfinity X1 triple play from Comcast and save when you bundle. See for yourself. Call 1-800-XFINITY or visit comcast.com today.
We didn't just break the mold, we made it. And we spelled it L-I-T-E. Because when you invent light beer, you get to spell it however you want. Spell different because it's brewed different.
To throw, good protection, throws deep up the sideline for Davis. Corey has it, down to the 10, down to the 5, and he is out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Up the boundary, Corey wrestles it away from the defender, and the Broncos have it first and goal at the 2.
Another big catch by senior wide receiver Corey Davis. That set up a 1-yard touchdown run by Jamari Bogan in the first half, but the Broncos got to that point because of the Bronco defense, stopping Illinois on a 4th down play to turn the ball back over to the offense. And PJ, just a tremendous victory. You're 2-0 in the Big Ten right now. You're on top of the Big Ten West.
You know what? We are. But we're really focusing on just the 1-0 season that we had, the 1-game season at Illinois. I'm really proud of our team for getting that victory. It took everybody. It took special teams. It took offense. It took defense. It was a collective effort. We didn't play a perfect game, but we played good enough to win. We got to clean up a lot of things as we move into Georgia Southern, but very proud of everybody, Bronco Nation, our band, David Montgomery, our entire team, our coaches, everybody, our administration, and everybody came out, supported us, and you could hear those Bronco fans the entire game.
I'll tell you, after the game, it sounded like a game at Waldo Stadium, if you were listening, because the Bronco band was playing, you guys were singing the fight song, it was great.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun, especially at the end of the game. You know, that's always fun to do, sing the fight song on the opponent's field. And really celebrate with our fans.
Great return to start the game by Darius Phillips out near midfield, but their defense got you stopped in this series.
They really did. They had an exceptional defense, especially their defensive line. They got 2 guys that are going to be drafted in the National Football League. Really, really good players up front. But we've got to start faster. It can't be about what they do. It's got to be what we do.
Coleman did a nice job punting for you in place of Derek Mitchell.
He did. You know, Derek had a little bit of an issue in pregame, so we just played it safe and went with James, and I thought he did a phenomenal job. He's a transfer from Virginia, and I'm glad we have him.
All right, here's your defense going to work, and they were just outstanding. They held Illinois to 315 yards and just 3 yards rushing. They hit a couple of pass plays on you, but Justin Tranquil breaks that one up.
You know, Justin's gotten better and better, and it was a nice pass breakup. The biggest thing about our defense is that, you know, we were able to get up early on them, 21-0, kind of took them out of their actual game plan, so they had to go to the pass probably earlier than they wanted to. But it worked for our advantage, that's for sure. It worked towards our advantage.
Here's another punt, and again, good coverage by your team. They had virtually nothing in the return game.
Yeah, you know what? This is why the how matters. The Austin Guidos, the Trevor Sweeneys, you know, the Drake Spears. Those guys are the first ones to the ball. Love our special teams. Love what Coach Wanger's doing over there. And they're playing with incredible passion and energy.
That's Vaughn, their tailback, and Broncos just bottled him up all day.
Well, we knew we were going to have to stop the run. We knew we were going to have to be able to do that because they're a really good running football team. They ran the ball well against North Carolina. Obviously, they ran the ball well against Murray State. We had to be able to stop them, and I'm really proud of our defensive staff and our players for executing the game plan.
That was the fourth down play. Then you come out and hit Carrington Thompson into Illinois territory, and then you go up top for Corey Davis, and he makes a circus catch over here and hangs on to the football and got you down there into the scoring zone.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know, but that throw was probably the best part about that whole thing. I mean, Zach Terrell's getting hit from both sides, and he's still able to find a way to get that ball to Corey.
Jamari takes it in from 1 yard out. Butch Hampton adds the point after, and the Broncos are on top 7-0.
Yeah, we had to start fast. We had to be able to come out of the gates, and we were able to do that, and it gave us the best chance possible. We couldn't play from behind with these guys. We had to be able to jump early, and we were able to do that.
All right, here you go on kick coverage. And again, the guy's doing a great job keeping them hemmed in. And here's that run defense. You know, Robert Spillane.
I tell you, it's so good to have Robert Spillane back. You know, we didn't have Robert last year for the most of the year. So really nice to have our leader back in the middle of our defense. Keon Adams coming on strong. I mean, he's playing so hard, so well. Jimmy Williams has been tremendous for him.
Yeah, the Jimmy Williams experience, you call it.
That's right. Jimmy Williams effect, actually.
Effect.
Yeah, yeah. The experience. Yeah, it is. It's both. It's an effect and an experience when you're with him. He's really changed our defensive line's play.
Here goes Jamari to the house for the touchdown. Big hole, and he took it the distance.
It's a lot of fun to see the holes like that open up. And then we got running backs that can finish, and I love that about these guys.
And another point after by Butch Hampton. He's been money on those.
He's done a tremendous job all year for a true freshman. Again, he's missed his first one the last few games, so we got to be able to clean that up and iron that out. But I'm really, really proud of him, the way he's been able to handle the pressure of everything that's been thrown his way.
More great kick coverage, and now here comes your defense going to work. You get some pressure on Lunt, and you force a turnover, and the Broncos come up with the football. That's Caleb Bailey picking up the loose ball and returns it down to the 5.
Yeah, just never stop playing. You never know. And the hand was going back. The ball was actually loose before the hand started going forward. And, you know, again, it was called a fumble. Now, if this was called a pass, maybe it'd be hard to overturn. But, again, we've gotten some calls like this. This has really helped. But this is just outstanding effort by Eric Asua. I mean, he's not even close to Wes Lunt, the quarterback, and he's able to still get that ball loose by just his how and his effort and his relentless pass pursuit.
Yeah, and he got to the quarterback despite being held and made the play. And now the Broncos down there again knocking on the door for another score. You change quarters, you swap ends, and Zach Terrell looks a couple of times over there to the sideline and then calls his own number.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, he called Jamari's, and then they obviously did that. Number 14 crashed down, and the crazy legs Terrell right here finds a way to make a guy miss. So he's deceptively agile, and you can see it right there.
And the Broncos open up a 3-score lead on the road against a Big Ten opponent at Memorial Stadium, where there's so much tradition. You talk about Red Grange and Dick Butkus and guys like that.
I tell you what, I grew up in the state of Illinois. I grew up an Illini fan, so I know all about their tradition. It was just a special place to play.
All right, back comes the Western Michigan defense, and Asante Brown and Caleb Bailey and Spillane and that D-line getting the job done. There's a Sue in there helping out again on a tackle, and they can't run, so they have to throw. And over the middle, and the Broncos secondary did a good job.
We did. We had a few that got behind us, so we got to be able to clean a lot of things up. We did not play a perfect game by any means. We've got a lot to get better at, and a lot of it starts with the secondary, and this is the stuff we cannot have. You know, we haven't turned the ball over yet, but we have fumbled once or twice, so we've got to clean that stuff up.
Was that Donnie Ernsberger on another
loose ball? Donnie Ernsberger found a way to get in there again. You know, thank goodness for Battle Creek Donnie Ernsberger.
There's Zach on another carry, and that time he stuck his nose in there a little bit.
You know, he's so tough, and he's willing to do what it takes to win a football game, and he's just one of those guys that lead by example.
All right, we're in the second quarter, and you're able to add some more points there on a field goal.
Yeah, we needed to be able to respond. It was 21-0. We missed the first field goal we had, so then they scored. It was 21-7. We had to answer, and we did with 24-7. So I'm glad that we were able to respond with scores to their scores.
Broncos on top at the half against a Big Ten team on the road, 24-7 Western Michigan. We'll be back with the second half highlights after this timeout on Bronco Review.
Are you considering home improvements? You should consider BlackBerry. For over 35 years, BlackBerry's installed windows, roofing, siding, and sunrooms, satisfying thousands of customers throughout West Michigan. Right now at BlackBerry, you can get 10 of our best-selling, high-performance, double-hung windows for only $44.50 installed. 18 months, no interest financing, and 10 windows for just $44.50 installed. Call today or go to BlackBerrySystems.com.
At Galesburg Ford, we all agree, we love football.
And I like the Honolulu blue and silver.
Brown and gold all the way.
I kind of like purple.
We may all cheer for different teams, but our team here at Galesburg Ford has one goal. That's to put you in the right car, truck, or SUV. So whether it's a brand new Ford
or a certified used vehicle,
now you can score your next vehicle at Galesburg Ford.
Touchdown!
Galesburg Ford.
Not too far for your next car.
I love my job, but I was so tired I could hardly get through the day. That's where I knew something had to change. The team at the Borges Heart Institute found a heart arrhythmia. After they treated me, I had so much more energy. That's where I started finding time for me again.
Watch more Borges patient stories at thatswhere.com.
When we decided to change our name to Arbor Financial Credit Union, we wanted a name that would better express who we are and what we stand for. We're about supporting your growth, whether that's into a new car, a new business, a house of your dreams, or a new stage of life. We're about supporting you and your family, as well as the communities we all share. Welcome to Arbor Financial Credit Union, where we continue to grow with you, just as we always have. Arbor Financial Credit Union. Bank here, grow here.
To the 10, to the 15, there is to the 20, 25, 30. He may not be caught this time, he will not. 20, 10, 5, touchdown. For Davis, he's got it for the touchdown. Corey Davis, touchdown, Western Michigan. Zach in the shotgun, gives it to Bogan, big hole right up the middle, into the secondary, to the 20, 15, 10, he's gone, touchdown Western Michigan, Jamari Bogan, 36 yards for the touchdown.
Jamari Bogan into the paint, one of his two touchdowns on Saturday against the Fighting Illini, and I'll tell you what, this guy is some kind of back, 189 yards rushing, Cole Mack West, Offensive Player of the Week.
You know what? Really, really proud of him. He's a lot in a little package, you know, and he's not that big of a guy, but he's so powerful. He's one of the strongest kids on our football team, one of the smartest kids on our football team off the field. And it's just kind of like the Zach Terrell effect and, you know, John Kinoy effect. A better player is a smarter player, not because just your grades, but being able to do all the little things correctly.
How about the Bronco marching band on the field?
Look at how many band members we have. Largest we've ever had here at Western Michigan, to be honest with you. Dr. David Montgomery's doing a fabulous job. I love going over there across campus and visiting the band.
All right, here comes Vaughn again. Nowhere to go. That's Robert Spillane with one of his 11 tackles. Mack West, co-defensive player of the week, Robert Spillane.
Yeah, you know what? He's getting better and better, and he's a tough guy. Just absolutely tough. And we missed him last year, and it's really glad to have him back. He's tackling a lot better than he ever has.
Hey, don't go anywhere when they're punting to Darius Phillips or kicking, because it could go the distance any minute.
He just has incredible vision, and he's got a great feel for it. Our team does a tremendous job. You know, this is a wonderful play. I think it was Drake Spears and Asante Brown. Just guys hustling down the field, making exceptional plays. This is a wonderful sack right there.
That's Asante Brown with one of two sacks, but you put pressure on him all day. He was hurried all day long, and Here comes Jamari again. Another run. This one went for over 40 yards.
Yeah, you know what? He just couldn't quite finish, get to the end zone, but I love the way he burst through that line. I love the way that he runs with confidence.
Added another field goal. You weren't able to punch it in the end zone, but you'll take those 3 points.
I'll take those 3 points. We prefer the touchdown, especially when we're that close. But, you know, we were able to, again, put more points on the board. It's we needed to keep them out of the end zone, keep them kicking field goals, and as long as we kept kicking field goals, we were going to be okay. But we had to keep putting points on the board.
Another thing we should mention is Butch Hampton was kicking off for you in this game, too.
He was kicking off, you know, with us deciding that we'll give Derek a week off, just rest him and not make that thing any worse. Then, you know, Butch went in there, and Butch has never done that for us. So Butch went in there and did that as a true freshman. Not only a true freshman kicker, now he's a kicking off, and that's a different entity. We did different things we've never done before, and we taught him right there on the sideline.
But he did an excellent job, and Bronco fans are having a ball. It's a beautiful day in Memorial Stadium, Champaign, and the Illinois fans there, as you can see, they're sitting on their hands most of the game.
Yeah, you know what? I heard the Bronco fans a lot, and yeah. I really appreciate everybody showing up to this game.
All right, Lunt goes up the boundary, and good coverage there by Obie Jackson.
Yeah, Obie's getting better. He's got a lot to learn, but he's playing really well for a young guy right now.
All right, on the punt, fair catch, and Western Michigan's offense goes back to work as the Broncos try and add to their lead. You know, you never have enough, right?
No, you never have enough, especially when you play a Big Ten team. So this is when we were going to possibly run out the clock. And, you know, when they play a single coverage, you got to take advantage of that with Corey Davis. But the ground game was working so well, 287 yards on the ground. We had to be able to throw the ball once in a while down to Corey.
All right, I loved this series because it was Jarvion Franklin, and I called it on the radio man-sized football, as Jarvion was down there with the men plays.
You know, he had to go finish the game, and I'm really, really proud of him for finishing the game and being able to put it away, get the last touchdown, and make a statement, and I'm glad he did that.
You know, your offensive and defensive line made a statement, and I think it made a statement in favor of your strength program and Coach Nickel, and we mentioned that on the broadcast too. Those guys have come a long way in the weight room, and it showed in this game.
We really have. I mean, remember Robert Spillane, he was a true freshman playing linebacker. He has no business. I mean, he's about 200 pounds playing middle linebacker. He had no chance. Dan Nickel is one of the best strength coaches in the entire country. Dan really cares about our players. He has relationships with every single one of them. A lot of kids don't like exactly what he has to say or how we're going to do it sometimes because he pushes them challenges them, but they appreciate the growth that they have, and he's an amazing human being, new father of two baby daughters with twins, and I think that softened him up just a little bit.
More pressure by the Bronco defense, get another sack here, and tell you what, that's Eric Asua and Nathan Braister got a piece of him too, and Western Michigan really just doing an outstanding job on defense all day long, and they're trying to throw from their own end zone.
Yeah, you know what, look at the stands. Everybody's kind of cleared out from there by then. You know, we just wanted to continue to put our foot on the gas, run the clock down, and get out of there with the W.
That's Jamari Bogan with another carry. Finished with 189 yards in this game. And here's some more hard running by the Broncos, and the clock runs out. You go over and shake hands with Lovey.
Yeah, good old Lovey Smith. You know, I mean, their staff's got over 56 years, I think collectively 56 years in the National Football League. And just wonderful for our staff that I know a lot of those guys don't know who our guys are, but it's nice for us to get that win.
That had to be fun, jumping into the students there.
I tell you, we have incredible fans. We got incredible students. You know, these guys made the trip. It really means a lot to us, and I'm so proud of the pride they have for Western Michigan.
And then they pick you up in the locker room. I think you kind of ran in there and dove into the pot.
I dove in there. We got to fix that ceiling tile. I'm sure we'll get a bill for that. But that's all right. I'll pay that bill of that ceiling tile. It was worth it.
Absolutely. Western Michigan, 2-for-2 against the Big Ten this season. In 3 weeks, Broncos 34, Illinois 10. We'll be back with more Bronco Review now this time out.
You trust Dunchy Body and Frame for all your collision repair work, but they offer so much more, from brakes and alignments to paintless dent repair. Dunchy works with all insurance companies and provides you with a lifetime warranty on collision repair and workmanship. So for the personal hometown service you want and the high-quality, no-pressure repair you deserve, give them a call at 375-2100 or visit them on the web at DunchyBody.com. Dunchy Body and Frame, part of your community since 1973.
Hi, I'm Jim Vandenberg with Maple Hill Subaru. Maple Hill and Subaru, they're becoming synonymous with best of quality, for the love, for the trust, everything that you want in buying a car. Consumers Magazine puts them as number one year after year. The only brand that's had three Motor Trend Car of the Year awards, the only SUVs that have ever repeated that many times in the past 5 years. We're proud to be a Subaru dealer.
Choosing a home isn't easy. This is where your kids will draw on the walls, where the people you love will gather to laugh and cry. It's a big decision, but choosing a mortgage doesn't have to be. At Arbor Financial, our knowledgeable staff will help you find a mortgage that's right for you, like our mortgage special with no money down, no PMI, and terms up to 30 years. You find the home, we'll make it easy. Visit us at arborfcu.org to find out more. Arbor Financial Credit Union. Bank here, grow here.
Little Caesars, home of the $5 Hot and Ready Classic, is driving your taste buds crazy with our new loaded crazy bread bites for just $4. We start with our world-famous crazy bread, cut into delicious bite-sized pieces. Then we amp up the flavor with creamy cheddar cheese sauce, mozzarella and Munster cheese, and tasty applewood bacon, all baked to perfection. Need more kick? We've added a side of jalapenos. Try our loaded crazy bread bites for just $4, only at Little Caesars.
Pizza, pizza. What if a home phone could also be a smartphone? And what if that home phone could save you money on your home and wireless bill at the same time? With Xfinity Voice, you get amazing technology like readable voicemail on your smartphone, caller ID on your TV, and even text messaging, all for a low price. Start saving with unlimited nationwide talk and text, and switch to Xfinity Voice for just $19.99 a month for 12 months. Call 1-800-XFINITY today.
One in the gun. Bronco's coming with the heat, and they got him back there for the sack. Asante Brown brings him down at the 19-yard line. Asante Brown with a second sack of the game for the Broncos. And Western Michigan's defense comes up with a big play.
Big sack by Asante Brown, one of many defensive plays by the Broncos in that 34-10 win last Saturday over Illinois. And PJ, the defense continues to evolve and gain an identity.
Yeah, they're gaining an identity, all right. They're becoming more mature. They're playing very well collectively as a group. They're playing in sync with each other. They're playing together, and they've gained more experience, you know, playing with each other. So I think that's the biggest thing we have. We have more experience we've ever had. We're deeper than we've ever been. Not where we want to be by any means, but we got to continue to change our best. And they're playing with, like, their hair on fire. You know, they really are. They're playing with incredible how and passion, and that's how defense is played.
Really starts up front with that D line. You've got David Curl, a senior, playing at one tackle. Andre Turner playing inside. He's had an outstanding season. Then Asua on one end and Keon Adams at the other. Keon, a senior, really the leader up there.
Yeah, and then we're rotating in Nathan Braister and Daniel Jackson and Wesley French and Tony Balabani. So we're finally getting eight guys that we can kind of rotate. Before we only had four guys playing. That was all we had that we had to play with. So. But again, Keon Adams is doing a great job leading that group. David Curl is doing a tremendous job leading that group. Proud of their development.
And you've converted a lot of these guys. Now, Keon Adams wasn't a D lineman when he came here. Asante Brown wasn't a linebacker. Just to name a few, Nathan Braister was an end. Now he's playing a little inside. And just those changes. Wesley French was playing on offense.
Yeah, he was, you know. And you know, the biggest thing for us is that we're going to take the best athletes and play them where we can truly get them on the field. And if the kid's not going to play on one side, where can we get him to play on the other side? We've got to create depth. And I think our players have really done a great job accepting that.
All right, outstanding job by that Western Michigan defense. And they're going to have to be at their best this week against a really good team, Georgia Southern. That's on deck when we return following this timeout on Bronco Review.
Hey, I'm Carter Osterhaus. What do you do when you discover something great? Well, you tell your family and friends about it, right? Well, that's exactly how Lake Michigan Credit Union became the fastest growing credit union in Michigan. With some of the best checking account rates in the nation and guaranteed low mortgage rates, word is spreading fast about Lake Michigan Credit Union. Anyone can open an account. So tell your friends, Lake Michigan Credit Union, the best place for your money.
Your home can look its best with a little help from BlackBerry. For more than 30 years, BlackBerry's installed energy-efficient replacement windows, sided homes with great-looking vinyl siding, replaced roofs, gutters, shutters, and doors. We have thousands of satisfied customers throughout West Michigan. Right now at BlackBerry, it's our home improvement sale. Save on upgrades to your home, plus get 18 months of no-interest financing. Call today or go to BlackBerrySystems.com.
I was teeing off on the 13th hole.
I watched the shot fade right. I felt dizzy, and then I fell backwards. That's where I almost died.
The doctors, the nurses, everybody there was just wonderful. I never gave up.
That's where I got my life back.
For my first trick, I'll switch one brother for another brother. Mom and Dad, will you help?
Abracadabra.
What happened to Alex?
I don't know. I didn't practice that part.
The switch works better at Galesburg Ford. We can trade in your old vehicle for a new Ford with innovative technologies like foot-operated lift gates and EcoBoost engines.
See why people are making the switch at Galesburg Ford.
Galesburg Ford.
Not too far for your next car.
A part of being a member at Arbor Financial Credit Union is the relationships and personal attention you get from our helpful and knowledgeable staff. But we realize you don't always have time for that. With Arbor Financial's secure mobile app, you can quickly check your balance, pay a bill, deposit a check, or find an ATM. In between, well, everything else. Visit us online at arborfcu.org for more information. Arbor Financial Credit Union. Bank here, grow here.
Franklin straight ahead into the end zone for the touchdown. Jeremion Franklin, touchdown, Western Michigan. Oh, you gotta love that. That's some man-sized football down there.
Jarvion had a really nice game.
He really did. He stepped up and really ran the ball hard, made a lot of crucial third down plays, really moved the change on first and second down, and set us up on first down, set us up for really manageable second downs. So instead of second and 10, we were in second and fours a lot, which really helped us.
All right, Georgia Southern up next, 7 o'clock kickoff at Waldo Stadium. This is a team the Broncos lost to a year ago on the road. They run that option attack, and they've got some weapons.
Got everybody back from last year, everybody back. So this is a team that beat us really, really good, and beat us by 26. They beat the MAC champs, Bowling Green, in the bowl game by about 30. So this is one of the best teams we'll face all year. It's the best team, I think, collectively, by tradition and what they do and their how and their athletes that we've played so far. So we got a wonderful opportunity. Expect everybody to be there at Waldo Stadium on Saturday night. It's going to be a lot of fun.
An assignment defense over on the defensive side against this option.
Yeah, you have to be able to play your responsibility. Everybody has one assignment. And if you don't do your assignment, it's an 80-yard touchdown. So we got our work cut out for us. We're going to learn from our past. We're not going to focus on it, but we're going to learn from it. And now we're going to be able to apply it to this year.
All right, good luck against Georgia Southern.
I appreciate it, brother Boat.
Call the Bronco Ticket Office, 888-4-WMU-TIX, or order them online at WMUBroncos.com. We'll see you there 7 o'clock Saturday night, Waldo Stadium, Western Michigan, and Georgia Southern. And Coach will be back here next week. We'll recap all the highlights of another Western Michigan game against Georgia Southern from Waldo Stadium. For Coach Fleck, I'm Robin Hook. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.